Welcome back, everyone. In this video, I picked up an M1 Mac Air, which is replacing my old MacBook Pro from 2012. Pros, cons, let's get into that. So really, I'm not a stranger from Apple products to PC products, Windows, macOS. I've used both of them. They both have their pros and cons. But for video editing, I have always used Final Cut Pro. Just because I used it in high school, I'm used to it, I like it, I know how it works, I'm too lazy to learn something new. So I have stuck with Apple products just so I can use that because they don't allow it on anything else. So this is my 2012 Retina MacBook Pro. I got used years ago for like $700. I still have no issues with it, except recently they have completely cut support for this computer. You can't get the new software updates. You can't get new app updates like Final Cut Pro. I can't get new updates on it now. It's been cut off. It's the end of its life. And I've gotten to the point where for $700, I've definitely got my money's worth out of it. But now with the new things like the Air, the processing power in this one compared to this one is a lot. So let's get into both of them. And I'll go over the things that I like and I dislike. So before I get into the computers themselves, I have the chargers out here and I wanted to show the difference between the chargers. So back in 2012, this big old chunky boy right here, if you can see, is 85 watts. And 85 watts will charge this thing. I mean, it's not fast charging, it's just a decent charge. And it has MagSafe. Everyone wants MagSafe back. They brought it back with the new iPhones. We want it back for these. Now, technically you can get one of those USB-Cs because that's another thing. The old school ones, they plug into the wall and the power brick is like the cord. That's how the cord is. You don't get anything else. However, with the new ones, you can actually plug it in with the USB-C. So if this cable gets screwed up, you don't have to buy a whole new one. You can just get a new cable, which saves so much time, so much hassle. Plus, they still have the ends the same, so you can put an extension on here like I did. These new ones, look at this little baby. This little guy right here is a 30 watt. And it charges just as fast as the old 2012 Retina. So you get more battery life on this one with a smaller charger compared to the old one, which has a really heavy, big battery in here that doesn't last as long with a huge power brick. So that is one of my favorite things when it came to the power consumption on it. So back in 2012, when this thing was new, this was rated at about 7 hours of life. Whereas these new ones, somewhere around 18 hours, depending on how you use it, but it's an insane difference in the battery performance. Now I'm gonna start out by saying the one thing that I dislike is the size. No matter in any of the M1s, they don't have anything on the Air or the Pro that is the same size. They don't have anything more than 13. So this is a 13 inch, this is a 15 inch. You can see the difference in size. Now it's something that I knew and I was waiting for a 15 inch, but I really wanted to get a new one. So if I put these one on top of each other, you can see that there is a decent difference. Now when it comes to a laptop, I'm not super picky. The 13 I've gotten kind of used to since I got it. I would like 15. 15 inch is just the perfect size for watching YouTube videos and editing stuff without needing an external monitor, but that's just my opinion. Now, as I was opening them up, you could see when I opened up the M1, it's as soon as you crack it open, it's on, it's working, it's ready to go. However, if you've left this one out for a while and it's gone into like a deep sleep, it can take upwards of like 10 seconds before you open it up and the screen actually turns on. Now, besides this one being a 13 inch and this one being a 15 inch, there is a huge difference in weight. And the cool thing about this is if you think about it, yes, this one's smaller, but the difference in weight for what it is, this is a faster computer. This computer has more battery life. This computer does so much more stuff, multitasking, than this one, and this one is so much heavier. I've got my scale up here, and I'm gonna compare the two. So let's start with the M1, the brand new one, and they both have the same little protective skins on there. So this weighs 3.36 pounds with that cover on there. This one also has a cover on here. It looks different, but it's from the same company, so same material. Oh, and let's put that on there. 5.31 pounds. It's a big difference, where this one, you can just kind of pick it up at the corner, and it's kind of like a tablet. It's so light. And one thing that I have been missing out on that I had no idea, my 2012 doesn't have this. Obviously, the new ones have this. Touch ID. I just put my finger on here, boop, computer's on. How cool is it? That is the coolest thing ever. Plus, you can use that stuff for payments and logging on to stuff. You just put your finger on there, boom, it's done. You don't have to type in a password. You don't have to remember the password. Just bam, it's there. This needs to be a thing on all computers. So I have Geekbench pulled up on both of these computers. And the lower the number, the lower the score, the higher number, the better. So it's a really good benchmark for CPUs to see how well they perform. So in 2012, a single core on this one scored a 662, and the multi-core scored 2599. Now, 8 years later, 1702 and 7386. The speed on this little thing is miles ahead, and you can tell. Going through web pages, rendering videos, everything is so much quicker. It'll blow you away if you're going from an old one to a new one. I can't explain how fast it is between the comparison. Now looking at the keyboards, now this has been a really big thing recently, is MacBook keyboards. Now the one that I have here is the good keyboard. This is the one that everyone loves. And I love typing on this. This is the best thing I've ever typed on. And I don't have any issues. The delete bar is not a little tiny thing, so delete's a decent size. The arrow keys, they're put off to the side. They're not weirdly shaped. I love that. Everything about this is good. The trackpad, of course, Apple is known for their trackpads. Some of the best trackpads ever. I've never had any issues with this. I love it. Moving over to the new one, it's basically the same thing. This is their revised version of the keyboard. It feels similar. I think it feels almost the same, but it's a little bit softer than the old one. The old one feels a little more clicky, then the new ones feel a little bit softer, but it's still a really good feel, so I don't have any complaints on that. Now, if you look at the two, the trackpad on the smaller computer is bigger than the old one. So they've upgraded this. And there's actually something I didn't know. This is not actually a physical button. It is a trackpad that, of course, does tracking stuff. It can move your mouse. But when you click on it, that little click that you feel and hear is actually haptic feedback. Just like in your phone, it vibrates underneath. Now I'm gonna move on to something that I know people have been complaining about, and I also hate it too. That is the I/O, the ports. This is the brand new one, you get two. That's it. You get two ports. These are the Thunderbolt 4 / USB-C. You get two ports. So if you're charging your MacBook, you get one port. And that's it. You can put a dongle with a bunch of different stuff. That's what I got recently. I got a dongle to put on there that has basically everything. It's got USB, it's got HDMI, it's got Ethernet port, it's got everything on it. And this is it right here. You can see it's got the card readers, it's got the USB-C so you can charge it while this is plugged in, so you have that. You got the 1 gig Ethernet, you've got HDMI, and you've got a bunch of USB 3 ports. So when that's plugged in, I can do a bunch of stuff to it, never have to run out of room. But if you don't have that, you get one port while you're plugged in and two ports total. It is ridiculous. Compared to the old one, you can see over here, headphone jack. That's the only thing on the other side is a headphone jack, which is nice. They didn't get rid of it. On the old one, you get the headphone jack, you get your USB, you get your old school Thunder ports, two, and you've got your MagSafe. On the other side, you got your built-in card reader, an HDMI port, and another USB. That is really, really good. The only thing I would say it's missing is an Ethernet port, but of course you could still get dongles put in there and you're good to go. Now, I'm not a big audio guy, but you can see we've got the speakers on both sides, the grills on here, and the new ones obviously have smaller speakers, but newer speakers. I feel like this one is way louder. So the brand new M1 is miles ahead, so much louder. But it feels, in my opinion, this one feels muffled, where this one is more crisp. It's kind of hard to explain, but I'm not big into audio. If I am, I'm wearing headphones. So everyday use is obviously much better on the M1. The M1 is newer, it's a lot snappier. This one, I got the 16 gig, so I never have to worry about anything throttling when it comes to RAM. And I think the biggest thing is I don't have to reset this one as much as I do this one. I've never had to reset this one for anything besides updates. Whereas this one, I've had zero issues. Everything is just insanely fast. So with the brightness turned all the way up, I don't think I really see much of a difference. They say that the MacBook Pro, the new one, has about 100 more nits of brightness. But I've got these both cranked all the way up. You can see them side by side. And really, you can't tell a difference at all. The only thing I would say is because this is a smaller screen, it is slightly sharper than my older one. But you really got to look into it to try to find the subtle differences. You really have to zoom and look in on text to actually figure that out. At a distance, a normal distance, they both look very crisp. Even this old, outdated one looks fantastic. Now I'm gonna do a test on two different websites, the exact same thing. I've got Amazon linked up in both of these. I'm gonna hit enter at the same time, and you're gonna see there's a little bit of a difference between the two. Let's just see. All right, so I have Pinterest pulled up here. Pretty common website for everyone. Now let's try Instagram. Maybe TikTok. Now you can see there is a decent difference between surfing the web and how quick and responsive it is. Now I can't tell you all the different things that I do where I can see little improvements just making the whole experience so much better. But I do have to say it is much better of an experience using the M1 than my old school one. Now, is it worth the money? Yes. And I do say that because you can get the base M1 MacBook Air, just bare bones, the cheapest one you can, and it's gonna perform basically the same as the one I have here. I spent a little bit extra on this one for the 16 gigs of RAM, and I also have a terabyte of memory in this one. However, I got this one refurbished, so it was about $300 cheaper than if I got it brand new, but this came out in 2020 at the end of the year, so it's still a new computer even if I got it refurbished. I paid $700 for this one years ago, and I've enjoyed it. I've definitely spent $800 worth of my time into this, so I've gotten my money's worth. Now this one is just a little bit more expensive if you just get the base, and now this one has access to all of the new updates in the future, and I'm sure it's gonna go quite a bit longer than this one has. With this chip, it being so much more powerful, this one has future access to all the updates. then I can no longer get on this one. My Final Cut Pro, if you use iMovie, if you use anything on here, all the updates are gonna continue. The new OS is coming out. That's gonna continue being a thing. And I can't do that on the old one anymore. So it's time for me to upgrade, and I am happy. The only thing I don't like is I want a bigger screen. Other than that, and the ports, I'm very happy with the new M1 Air. Okay, I hope you guys enjoyed this video comparing 2012 to the new 2020 M1 Air with its new processor and whatnot that Apple has done. Fantastic job on this, and really, I just want something a little bit bigger, and it is amazing. Absolutely blown away by the technology improvements. So I'll see you guys in the next video, and honestly, I have no idea what it'll be. It's always random.